Hi, hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host, Game Hunter, and welcome back to another episode of Song of Horror. Hopefully today we're going to end up finishing episode 2 if everything goes to plan and I don't end up cocking it up and killing the characters off. So yeah, let's get back into it. Looking forward to getting back into this one again, so let's go. Gotta try and remember where we got to. I think we just got the bottle of Luminol from Erica's apartment, if I'm not mistaken. So we shouldn't be too far away if we don't end up eating any of the bloody other things for breathing tests, because I don't seem to be able to do very well with them breathing flipping things. So let's see what we've got. Hydrogen peroxide spray bottle, Luminol. So yeah, this is the bathroom where we just got the bottle of Luminol, so that's fine. Just gotta work out this, and we've got to go back. Go back to the apartment of the antique guy to see if we can open. Oh god. If I remember how to get there, that is. Down you go, sweetie, come on. Right, are we at the bottom yet? No, we're not. Keep going. Yes, we are. Bing bangs empty gas bottles. Notice, no notices for me, that's fair enough. There's a dark room, but how do we get there? Can we come through here? I think we did. How do we get upstairs? Can I go through there? No. Here. had an ease lead. Main entry is called Dado Esport Futures Shop, so we can't go through there. Elevator's broken, so. So why are we in block two? That's still not where we need to be. Ah! Oh, what am I doing? Come on, wake up. Jesus. Get back into the shop. Right. So is it this door? Leads to the flats. I think we've got on the case now. Yes, so straight through the main door at the end. Yes, this is it. So we just need to get to the dark room. And it's the first door. Is it this one? Yes, it's looking like it. Aha, here we are. Oh my good God, what we got here. Millimeter to stabilize the glass, the final of the product. Okay. A is hydrogen plus oxide, B is the methanol sulfoxide, C is the stabilizer, D is distilled water. If you have any trouble, remember that bottles A and B are the same size and their taps are identical. When you find it, get some hydrogen. Right. So let's restart that. So I've got to reopen A. And go across to C. The jar goes down quite quick.
Yes.
Whew, that was a bloody thing, wasn't it? Then we use the empty bottom. So now we've got a bottle of luminol. Nice. So I think that's all we need to do in here. So let's go back. Dark and rainy as well, that's always not a very nice thing in Nissan games. Right, so what we got here? Looks like a handle, but oh, we could use a wrench on that, can't we?
Broken my legs.
Oh, come on, love, grow up a bit, would you? Walters at Sullivan, security agent, number 909534. No, this way, that's it.
Mm-hmm.
A square torch, an old school torch with a clip attachment. Right. Pays belong to the dyers from block one. As long as they keep saving us money by fixing things up, nobody cares where they keep their tools. Okay. Anything in here? No, it seems pretty quiet. Has it breathed? Yes, it will. Let's just grab a quick list again. No, it sounds quiet.
Okay, let's see whether I'm able to follow the bloody trail.
I'm guessing these are the sort of rooms. This is another door we can hide in. finds this corridor. That's another room we can hide in. This is getting quite a flipping on the heads of receipt stuff now. I think it's gone quiet. Jesus Christ. Right, let's keep going. I think it's gone quiet again. Got to be getting close to the end now. This could be just like this, just running backwards and forwards. That's amazing. got lost, completely lost. Crazy. Wait a minute. Ooh, I think we found
it. This is the wardrobe that Dad cleaned off in the courtyard. What's that tape doing here?
It's gone. The box isn't here. I've got it. I've had it all this time. How could it be possible? What the devil is happening to me? I have to get to my office. I must wrap it and send it to its owners. Grant Amsberg. They're the ones who... My office. I'm going to... I hear them crawling all over and screaming. Erica, come to my office. We'll all be there.
So now we've got to get our way out. Get the hell out of here. Need to get back to the apartment of the antique. God, that was a crazy little ride, that was. Oof. At least we didn't lose any more characters. Right, so where is he?
If I can open it with this. Oh no. Oh.
Oh my God.
Dad!
Wow. Jesus.
There was Faber. God. Don't even want to think about what must have happened in his final moments. As he was hanging from that noose with the bloody music box on the table. I don't want to think about it, but somehow, very deep within me, I know the song was playing throughout his agony, stalking him to the very frontier between life and death. God. At least we had found the music box, and we knew where it came from. Le Grand Amesburg Auction, it said, on the list of product lots, alongside an address. According to Husha, things had improved after returning the box to Faber. So by returning it to its owner, perhaps we might be able to solve all this. It sounded unlikely, but considering my hallucinations, the things we found at the antique shop and Mr. Faber's terrible end, if it could all come to some good, we had to try it. Isolated far from the world, in a holiday manor that must be about 100 years old, the lady who owned the sinister box awaited us. For my little Ariadne read the engraving on the inside of the cover. Good. For her, then.
Doesn't look like the mansion is number 2, 3.
Do you think that someone could actually live in this place?
I don't know. The papers from the auction stated that the owner had sold most of her furniture, but that she still lived here. Mr. Grant? Hello? This place gives me the creeps. Hello? Are you Miss LeGrant? Ariadne LeGrant?
Amesburg.
Pardon me?
Le Grand Amesburg. It's hyphenated.
Oh, well, my name is Daniel Neuer, and I work for a publishing firm. Through a series of chance occurrences, I found something I believe is yours. It seems crazy, but when you listen to it...
That's its box.
No. I think it belongs to you. On the cover, it says...
I wasn't speaking to you. Thank you for bringing it back, Mr. Neuer. Have you listened to it?
Yes.
He has listened to it.
Oof. Damn.
Just what I was thinking. Let's get out of this place.
Absolutely. I'm glad we got rid of that thing.
Me too. I'm sorry it wasn't in time to...
I know. Thanks.
Come on. I'll take you to the shop.
That same night.
Thanks for giving me a place to stay. I think the walls would come closing in on me if I were alone.
It's no trouble, Dan. You're going to be paying for any pizza, though.
Of course. You can sleep in your bed. I'll stay here on the couch.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Have a good rest, Sir Daniel.
You too. Hey, Lydia?
Oh, no.
Daniel, are you all right?
No, just seeing
things. That had not been a nightmare. I was awake, for certain. It was a hallucination. A hallucination like those described by Faber in his letter, shortly before hanging himself from a beam in his office. A hallucination. Or something worse. Much worse. Had it done any good to return the music box to its owner? Husha might have the answer, but his whereabouts was still unknown. And his trail seemed to have gone cold as the days passed by. Perhaps in his office, somewhere in his papers. Among the documents he was researching while delving into the box's origins. Maybe there would be some clue in there as to where he had gone or what he had done. Something that would help us to follow his footsteps. I had to find Sebastian Husha, but this time, my life depended on it.
Right, well, there we go then, guys. That's the end of episode 2. Really good, certain very weird ending to that one, so I'm looking forward to getting into episode 3 next week. But for now, guys, hope you enjoyed the end of episode 2 and the story where it's going, and I will see you all very, very soon. So take care, guys, be safe, and talk to you soon. Bye-bye for now, guys. Bye-bye.